And when we get knocked down, we get back up.
Yeah.
And so for the last 3.5 years, we worked to make sure that we didn't slip into the Great Depression. And we created 4.5 million new jobs.
Woo!
We saved an auto industry on the brink of collapse.
Look out.
We know that we still got a long ways to go. The medical ones are coming right here. But you know what hasn't changed?
She said it might be her blood sugar.
Yeah, we got a kid.
What's great in the past is going to make us great in the future. Everybody plays by the same set of rules. We're here to build an economy where hard work pays off, so that no matter who you are or where you come from, you can make it if you try. That's what this campaign's about, Colorado. That's what the choice is in November. And that's why I'm running for second term as president of the United States. The idea is that somehow
through his.
Two cops says that this is going to lead to jobs and prosperity for everybody. That's what they're proposing. I'm not making this stuff up. Go to their websites. look at what the House Republicans voted on their budget. That's where they're going to take us if they win. That's their idea. And look, if you believe in that idea, then you're probably not going to be voting for me. Mr. Romney's the centerpiece of his entire economic plan is a new $5 trillion tax cut. On top of the Bush tax cuts, a big chunk of it going to the wealthiest Americans. And last week we found out that he expects you, middle-class families, to pay for it. Governor Romney's tax plan, this is not according to me, this is according to independent analysts. Assuming he kept his promise that it wasn't going to add to the deficit, would mean raising taxes on middle-class families with children by an average of $2,000. And keep in mind, this would not be an $8 deficit. It wouldn't be to grow jobs, invest in education, or make college more affordable, or invest in science and research, or clean energy, because he wants to cut all those things. He wants to cut away that stuff. Your tax increase would be to pay for another $250,000 tax cut for people making more than $3 million a year. How many people think that's a good idea? Incredible job growth in this country.
No.
We have tried this before. They tried to sell us this turned down tax cut very dozen before. And guess what? It didn't work. It didn't work then. It won't work now. It's not a plan to create jobs. It's not a plan to cut the deficit. It's not a plan to move our economy forward. We don't need more tax cuts for folks like me. We need tax relief for working families. For folks who are trying to make sure your kids get a good education. Try to keep your kids healthy. Try to keep a roof over their heads. Try to send them to college. That's the choice in this election. That's why I'm running for the second term as president of the nation. Their tax burden is about $3,600 lower than it is now. I want to keep taxes exactly where they are for the first $250,000 of everybody's income. I've already told Congress what's getting done. We should do it before the election. Now, if your family makes under $250,000, which, by the way, is 98% of American families and 97% of small businesses, under my plan, your income taxes would not increase a single dime next year. To be in the other 2%. If this country has blessed you the way it's blessed you, you still get a tax cut on the first $250,000 income. It's just that after that, we're going to ask you to contribute a little bit more. So we're going to be responsible and invest in things like helping young people go to college. And by the way, this doesn't mean that we don't still have more work to do to make government more efficient. I'm not somebody who believes government can solve every problem. Government has to do its part by cutting out spending that we don't need. We've already cut $1 trillion. A trillion, that's with a T. Out of our budget. So, and we can do more to make government more efficient, more customer friendly. But that doesn't do enough to bring down the deficit. So all I'm asking is that folks like me go back to the rates that we paid under Bill Clinton, which, by the way, you may remember, we created 23 million new jobs. the biggest budget surplus in history. And we created a whole bunch of millionaires to boot, because what happens is, when a construction worker or a police officer, they've got no more money to spend, you know what, maybe they go out and buy that new car. And suddenly the car company has more profits, which means they hire more workers. And everybody does that. Of America. When we grow from the middle class up, when we provide ladders of opportunity for those who want to get into the middle class and are willing to work hard to do it, everybody does well. Top, middle, bottom.
Let's make sure that we take some of those savings that we're spending after a decade of war
support. Let's do some nation building here at home.
Thank you.
Let's put people back to work.
Yeah.
Rebuilding our roads and our bridges.
Yeah.
Laying broadband lines. Rebuilding our schools. Putting in new science labs. Yeah, I was just down in Pueblo, and we were talking about a water project that John F. Kennedy had signed authorizing 60 years ago, 50 years ago, has never been funded. You know what? Under my administration, it's getting funded. There are projects like that all across America, and we can put people back to work right now. That's good for the economy right now. Lower unemployment right now, but it also lays the foundation for economic growth for decades to come.
Yeah.
That's a choice in this election. I believe that we, once again, should be leading the world in educating our kids. So I said, let's make sure that we're helping local school districts hire the best teachers, especially in math and science. And community colleges so people can train for the jobs that businesses are hiring for right now. And I want to make college and university tuitions lower so young people aren't broke. Because they get sick.
Yeah.